One of the best experiences about writing Stella's biography was getting to know Harold Clurman. And I didn't even realize I was getting to know him until a month ago. It starts out when he's born and she's born. They're born the same year with the same goal, which is to create an American theater, although they didn't know it. So I start out when he's born, and he's also born on the Lower East Side, and his boyhood hero is Jacob Adler. So instantly I identify with Clurman. And he was unconditionally devoted to Stella. This was something that Stella did not have as she was growing up and had never experienced unconditional love before. She didn't get it from her mother, which is where most of us get it. And so she needed Clurman on a deep level. They influenced each other, supported each other, inspired each other creatively. But there was this other aspect of their relationship where she embodied for him the theater that he strove for, and he embodied for her a home and the type of love that she had never experienced before. And so, beginning with his life and then up until the end, I'm writing about him, not realizing how attached I have become to him. And one of the stories that's my favorite is that Harold has been asked to talk about acting, of all things, because he was the dean of the theater, so he could go on and on about directing and about theater and theater history, but acting was Stella's purview. So he's invited by Jack Garfine to talk about acting amongst his colleagues. And Stella calls up Jack and says, "I want a seat third row back from the front and center." And there's no seating, but he obliges her. And so she's there when Clurman comes on stage. And they all expect him to be Father Divine, as Clurman was, shouting and being passionate and inspiring them about the theater and talking about acting. And he comes out and the audience can barely hear him. So he has to go backstage, and Dustin Hoffman goes to Jack Garfine and tells him, what's going on? You have to help him out, whether it's Harold Clurman or Laurence Olivier, this is your job. So Garfine goes back, and Harold is pacing. He's pacing, and he's talking about how, I know what she's thinking. She thinks I can't talk about acting, and Garfine knows that it's Stella that he is so upset about. And he tells him, use that energy, as any great director will, to go out there and do a good job. So Harold marches back out on stage, looks directly at Stella in the front and center, and tells her, "Some people think I don't know about acting. Well, I'm going to talk about it anyway." So unbeknownst to me, I've become attached to Harold Clurman. And I say unbeknownst because I had no idea. It was all about Stella, always about Stella, and understanding her and her motives and explaining her debate with Lee Strasberg and why it was, and the father and the mother and the tradition that she, the nostalgia, the insecurity, and I'm reading the book for the first time without having in mind editing, repetition, pacing, arc, character arc, just reading it through for the first time, and it took about a day and a half. And when Harold passed, I was crying, and it was such an odd reaction, and I felt the loss for the first time. I felt, wow, I've become attached to this person that I never met, whose life I researched, and I can actually feel a loss when he died. It's a really tender moment, and I'm lucky to have in the hospital between him and Stella, and I'm lucky to have gotten someone told me about it that was present. So that's Harold.